im Schenkstchen.
Lay me there with a barrel of beer and a cup in my right hand. And over me coffin sing this cheer. He died a drunk, but a gentleman.
Think I know how to free Dandelion. Got a plan. But we need Doodoo. Gotta find him.
This plan? What is it?
Our Doppler friend will assume Menga's form. Order Dandelion move to Oxenfurt. We can grab him on the way.
Brilliant. But how do you aim to find Doodoo?
You're his friend. Any idea where he might be hiding?
With the Doppler, the question's never where, but as whom. In the past, facing trouble, he'd disappear, then reappear on the morrow with someone else. But this time he hasn't returned.
We need to convince Doodoo to reveal himself. Any friends we could leave a message with, someone he trusts?
Dandelion. Irina Reynard's troop, that's all, really. Not certain he was friendly with anyone else. Spent dawn till dusk with the troop, on stage or in the crowd.
So he liked going to the Mummings?
Yes. I'm actually surprised he didn't come to us after it all happened. He certainly could have counted on the Foxen's help.
So if these mummers are ready to help...
We need only mention Doodoo. Irina and company are deeply indebted to him.
Maybe we could use a play. You know, work a message to Doodoo into something. Lure him out of hiding that way.
Not a bad idea, but I doubt a few lines would suffice. Besides, do you really think Doodoo whiles away his days attending mummings he knows by heart?
So what do you suggest?
We must write an entire new play. From scratch. Something grand. Something that will grab Doodoo's attention. So most importantly, it must have a splendid title. It must be the talk of the town. If you wish, we can start on it right away.
All right. Guess we can start writing the play.
Any ideas for the plot?
Actually, I was hoping...
The key is to convince Doodoo that he can rely on you, and that we wish to free Dandelion. The message must be clear, though naturally woven into the play's dramaturgical essence, meaning we need an appropriate dramatic structure. Following along?
More or less.
That'll do. Now to find the proper expressive form for our content. A gripping, contemporary story, that would be best. Perhaps about the condottieri of Povis. I know. Lorenzo Moller. A tale of a handsome but ruthless bandit and the Doppler who manages to fool him. But now the Doppler must hide and can only count on the help of his friend, who's a witcher, who in turn is prepared to do anything to save his daughter. No, better. His beloved. What do you think?
Sounds great.
Really think so? Lorenzo Moller. Yeah. Or perhaps not. Wait, I've got it! We shall stage a story of the Urchin of Erlenwald. Secret lovers, their betrothal, a curse, a cruel queen, bells sounding midnight.
But...
At which point he reveals his face. He's a monster, there to steal Princess Parvetta. They want him dead, but at that instant a witcher steps in. And everything ends splendidly. So it's settled, yeah? You wish to say something?
We need a good title. Venture to say that's more important than the story itself.
I've some ideas. Perhaps you can choose.
Gonna consider my opinion this time?
Of course. We're partners in this. I'm just in charge. I've two really good ones. The Doppler's Salvation and A Changeling Rescued or The Witch's Triumph. Which do you prefer?
Let's go with The Doppler's Salvation. It's shorter. Catchier. Just one problem. No Dopplers in that story. Just a princess and a cursed urchin.
Nothing simpler. We need merely swap the Doppler in for the urchin. The message, that's what's important. A witcher arrives and saves the Doppler. Got it?
All right. So it's a comedy.
I was thinking more along dramatic lines. But if you prefer something lighter... Listen, merely decide and I'll get to work.
You're right. A drama'd be better.
Very well. I must get to work. While you must pick a corner, sit down, read silently, or just think. All right?
Fine, since you don't need help with the writing.
Geralt, wait. A rhyme for witcher?
Did itcher?
Ugh, just keep quiet. Done. I could make a small masterpiece of this had I a bit more time, but...
We're fresh out of that. The hidden message to Doodoo. What did you weave in?
Hidden message?
You were gonna work something in, like come to the Kingfisher at dawn, or...
That wouldn't be in keeping with the tone of the play, not at all.
You wrote it to contact Dudu. That was the purpose. Fine. So how do you see this working?
I don't know. I was counting on recognizing him by his scar. Or just improvising. Shall we worry about that later?
Ladies and gentlemen, most honorable citizens of the hallowed city of Novigrad, welcome. We have for you a tale moving and heartbreaking. Its title, The Doppler's Salvation. The players, Witcher Geralt as himself, Katarina as the queen, Leo Ribe as the humble servant, appearing as the prince, a veteran of the Novigrad stage, Abelard Ritza, and as the princess, the lovely Trebaritz with the voice of a nightingale, Priscilla.
Majesty, the Monster Slayer awaits. Your summons he's answered and stands at the gates.
Show him in. I must speak to the man. Lest that dread beast take my daughter's hand. Witcher, your task is a matter most tender. Her monster shall show a tonight's feastly splendor. Stand guard, beware, kill the beast if he shows, and a grateful queen shall reward your woes.
To slay beasts most foul, 'twas for this I was made. I kill as my calling, not just to get paid.
He swallowed the bait, this fool of a witcher. I'll ensure the foul bow reveals his true figure. The monster revealed, the witcher shall strike. The beast will he slay, thrust his head on a pike.
Oh, my child will pity her love, this beast, but a fiend and a maid. No, this must cease.
Gathered are we, a host fair and noble, to celebrate this day. The princess's betrothal.
Alas, no monster do I see or hear. Perhaps midst the guests he hides in fear.
My dear, long have we hid our love's tender fires. In stealth we'd meet, in deceit like liars. Tonight shall it end, be my wife. That's my plea. Our hearts torment over. We shall love for centuries.
Oh, darling, I will.
Wait, with wine must we toast this moment joyful. If not, a foul curse shall rend your lives woeful.
Treason, 'tis not wine, but a brew spiked with silver. Soon all shall see my true monstrous figure.
Hark, hark, 'tis no prince, but a Doppler impostor. Seems men's hearts can love for changelings foster.
Behold, Witcher! The beast of which I spoke. Unleash your sword. Let fly the killing stroke.
Stop, stop, beast or man. 'Tis my love, my betrothed.
Sheath your blades, fear a Doppler. 'Tis a thing most foolish. Changing one's shape does not make one ghoulish. Remember, 'tis not flesh a monster makes. but a heart that is base, such as in this knave aches.
Witcher, 'tis true. This wretch's foul suspicions tainted my mind with this plan so malicious. The Doppler must live. My daughter he'll wed. Beast or man, she loves him truly, without dread.
'Tis our tale's end, good folk, and its moral is this. No monster is he whose shape can shift.
The Witcher is just. A true Doppler's friend. But you, foul page, in chains you shall end.
Guard! Call the guard! Remove the traitor at once!
Hey, hear the princess's command? Come up here.
Come on then, Governor. Up you go. On stage.
Toss the traitor scum in the dungeon!
Don't be afraid. In the end, everyone will live happily ever after. Doppler and Princess wed the same night. The servant's heart melted. He wept at the sight.
Doppler's to the stake! Burn them all!
He's right. Oi, mamas! Don't know the Eternal Fire's commandments?
Blasphemers! Ought to teach them respect for the faith!
What are you on about? Shut the fuck up and clap before I tear your new arseholes!
Take more than threats to keep us quiet!
That's all right, I'll try me knuckle dusters. Come here!
Rumble time! Stop walking into his soul! He takes in!
All right, lads! Fun's over! Back to the axes!
Geralt, you recognized me. How'd you do it?
Greetings, Dudu. Heard about that souvenir Horson left on your face.
So, you know everything? Have you seen Ciri?
No. Still looking for her.
Geralt! Masterful! You did great. Haven't they laughed that hard in ages? Lads won't believe it when I tell them.
Explain one thing to me. How'd you and Dandelion manage to displease Reuven, Horson, and the Temple Guard all at the same time?
It's not as if we planned it.
I know Ciri went back to Horson's to get you. How'd you manage to escape?
I ran after, wanting to keep up, but I'd have been a hindrance. She called out to me, entreated me to shapeshift and disappear. I tried to find them, Ciri and Dandelion. It was as if they'd turned to vapor. Fearing for my life, I shifted each day, becoming someone else. Even considered turning into Ciri to trick her pursuers, but...
Slow down, Marmalade. Geralt, when did you last see Cirilla? Been a while, hasn't it?
A while, yeah.
And me, likewise. Must be a full-grown lass by now. Do us a wee favor. Show us Ciri for a moment.
Geralt?
Transform. Change into her.
I feel strange. Both of you staring at me bug-eyed. Is that enough?
Yeah, plenty. Bad idea.
Not angry with me, are you, Geralt?
No.
I feel relieved.
And Dandelion? Were you able to find him?
Witch hunters nabbed him, but there's good news too. We think we can free Dandelion. Just need your help.
What could I do?
Take on Menga's appearance, then go and give the order for Dandelion to be moved to Oxenfurt.
We'll lie in ambush in a ravine en route. Spring Dandelion from the convoy when it rolls by.
Wait, not so fast. How am I to be Menger? And I've no notion where Dandelion's being held.
Listen, you'll manage. Everybody believes Menger's missing. You can make up any story you want.
My lads and me will lie in ambush in the ravine. Geralt will then join us and we'll await word from you.
But how am I to contact you as Menger? Send word that the convoy's left.
You'll need to figure that out. Come on, Guile's your middle name.
So, we all clear? Dudu, get your ass to Temple Isle. I'm off to assemble my crew. And we'll be waiting for you, Geralt.
Yeah, see you in the ravine.
Whoa, wait! Hold on! What happens after? I hope you don't expect me to continue as Menger, live like Chapelle, burning the occasional heretic to keep up appearances?
No. Once it's over, we expect to see you at the Rosemary in Time, where we'll all meet.
To get pissed like wild badgers. So, settled? Let's get to work.
Seems everything's ready.
Aye. Soon as we catch sight of them, we'll block the road against the whole unit if need be. And, you know, I think it's a great plan all round, and I'm always glad to help. And it's not like I'm not eager to crack some holier-than-thou bugger skulls, but seeing as we've got a Doppler, wouldn't it have been easier to have him release Dandelion and be done with it?
Too suspicious. Think about it. Menger disappears, then shows up with a scar on his face to release Dandelion?
I suppose you're right.
What are you doing here?
Some child brought a note from Dudu. The convoy will leave at dawn. May I stay with you? I can't stand it. Sitting at home, worrying about Dandelion.
Never fear, my dear. You'll get your warbler back. Just hope he's got his... Damn it! Gotta watch the rhymes in the presence of a lady.
Go back to town.
Please, I shan't be any trouble.
Oh, come on, Geralt. Leave it go. Let her stay. Look at her. Oh, weepy-eyed. Like my Mutsy when his guts knotted up.
Fine, she can stay. On one condition.
I know. As soon as the fighting starts, I'm to stand at a distance.
Not much happening just yet. And there may be some time before it does.
Well, how about a game of Gwent?
Don't really feel like it. You two play.
All right. You know the basics. That's clear. Now we can play for real.
They're coming! They're coming now!
Priscilla, stay here. Dandelion. Damn it.
Geralt, go after him. Leave me here, Geralt.
Shit.
Lost him.
Got up through the tracks.
Tell me, one of them hunters barged into our hut, turned us out before we could so much as fart in protest.
There another man with him? Tall, dark-haired?
Aye. Jabbering the whole time.
Dandelion. So, Hunter's barricaded himself inside? There another way in?
Truth be told, there is.
Want to get rid of this Hunter or not?
Honest? We'd see you all gone. But he'll do for a start. Here, the key. Cellar door around the back.
And how can I be sure that you won't try anything?
I'll go with you. Not like I really have a choice now, do I?
And there'll be no trickery along the way. I could wring your neck like a fat hen, you realize?
Yes, but I also realize you won't. My corpse is worth nothing to you, where you've made a wise choice. Very wise. Might not be more than a sergeant today, but tomorrow...
Quiet! I thought I heard something.
What? No, you see, me and Gags, we don't...
Geralt, must you ruin everything? I had him just where I wanted him. It is good to see you, friend. Been a while since you were last in Novigrad. What's...
Come on, we'll talk outside.
Priscilla! What are you doing here?
You all right? You have me worried sick.
Dandelion, you rascal! Got this lass to thank for his racing after years. She chivied and chivied.
Shame you arrived too late to see us hoodwink that hunter. I had a plan all set, but then Geralt...
Dandelion, I need to ask you something. It's important, so focus. Where's Ciri?
Ciri? I thought, seeing how you're here, you haven't seen her? I don't know where she is.
When did you last see her?
We were on Temple Isle, running from Horson's men. What an adventure. One minute we were pulling off the heist of the century, the next we were prey. A pack of hunters on our tail.
Yeah, a splendid story, but I think I've had my fill of this boasting. Come, Zoltan. We must convince the halflings they saw nothing at all.
Gave me enough material for a volume of ballads. And this one will sell like hotcakes.
That all you care about? The ballads this'll inspire? Egos swell a bit lately. Getting more and more selfish with age.
What is that about?
It's about Ciri.
Why would I ever worry about her? You have any idea how she fights? The girl can take care of herself, believe me. Anyway, she's got to come back for that little box. The trinket that started it all.
Mean this?
You get it from Horsen? Whoa, Ciri will be overjoyed. Horsen, on the other hand, has got to be pretty furious.
Ciri ever tell you what this is? And Horsen, why'd she go to him with it?
She went to Horsen because I took her there.
Could have guessed that was your idea.
What? Her magic bauble was broken. Horsen had access to the mages who could fix it. Besides, she needed help deciphering a curse. It's incantation.
Know any more about the curse? Something specific, a detail, anything?
Well, I know the words.
You're kidding.
No, they were elven. Ciri was constantly repeating them to herself. Probably not to forget. Went like this. Vafail Elaine Kiadmil Foli. Gladiv Dorn Ep Tenaid Bundro Isne Iakas.
Doesn't mean a thing to me.
Even less to me.
She slipped away again. I was so close.
She came here from Velen. Somebody there helped her, apparently. Maybe she went back.
Doubt it. Talk to the Baron there. He's the one helped Ciri. Said she rode off to Novigrad to look for Yen and me. And Yen's in Skellige, looking into traces she thinks Ciri left behind there.
So, Skellige?
Skellige.
You two have chatted enough. Now it's my turn to talk to Dandelion.
And I'll gladly have a go at him when you're done. Let's get back to the Rosemary in time.
Well, I've certainly had my share of excitement for one day. A juicy roast in a soft bed with fluffy pillows. I think that's the least I've owned. We haven't seen each other, talked in ages. Consider dropping by if you're in the area.
I'm sure to be by sometime soon.
I'll hold you to that, Geralt. See you soon. And thanks again for today.
Portrait of the Hierarch. Nice.
It's nothing really.
Just one hitch. Coin. So, if you happen to get a break between drowners and ekamajigs, maybe you can help an old friend out.
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
She said something that made me think she's not entirely normal.
What?
That you're responsible, got your feet planted firmly on the ground.
You're pulling my leg.
Not this time. One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Ugh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am? She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time to die.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla, she's...
What? Speak, man.
She's badly, been attacked. They took her to Volmerius Hospital.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
Of course, let's go.
Gods. Priscilla. Is she gonna live?
Well, I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Oxenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery?
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week, a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do. I
would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again, I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. Ready and intrigued. I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Hemelfart himself.
Thanks.
Calluses on the fingers, sawdust in the beard, clothes sticky with sap. Must be our dwarf.
Excellent. I trust you don't grow weak in the knees at the sight of blood?
Not a bit. Start the autopsy.
Where?
Let's look at his head. Hair smells like it's burnt, like he was in a fire.
Notice anything else? That his eyes have been scooped out, for instance?
Let's examine the mouth. Burns, blisters.
Just like Priscilla's.
See this? Incision made into the voice box.
Indeed, so thin as to be nearly unnoticeable.
A small, extremely sharp instrument. Scalpel.
Yeah, but why? The wound is too small to bleed, and there are signs of swelling. The murderer... I believe he performed a tracheotomy, so the victim wouldn't die too soon.
Those burn marks I see in his eye sockets.
Yes, and some gray dust. Ash, it seems. Very fine.
Murderer gouged out his eyes, then put burning coals in the sockets.
So it seems. Looking at the wounds, it appears our woodcarver was still alive when it happened.
Let's examine his torso.
What have we here? Deep wound on the left side of his rib cage, and a scar the length of his stomach.
Let's examine the chest wound. Yeah, heart carved out, wound cauterized.
Wait a minute, there's something else.
An egg from an amphibian. A salamander? Scorched but intact.
I attended some lectures in herpetology as a student. Afraid I don't recall any amphibians that would lay eggs in corpses. So either Professor Cochrane was deeply mistaken, or this is our murderer's doing.
Look at the scar. Wounds long and thin, an incision. But the edges are ragged.
Means nothing. Look, no swelling, no bruises. An old injury, perhaps an accident in the workplace.
Open the abdominal cavity.
At due warning, it will stink of rot.
Once fought a Zugel up to my waist in sewage, so I doubt... Wait. Smells not rot.
Formaldehyde. A medical novelty. Heavily diluted, it's remarkable at preserving organic tissue in stronger proportions. It's more destructive than acid.
Explains why there's no smell of decay, and why his throat's scalded. Look at his hands. These welts. Rope burns, right? He was tied up.
I'd expect so. No one could sit through such torture unless bound.
Speaking from experience?
Yes, that of a victim. Spent a year in the dungeons of Tretagor. Long story.
Some other time, maybe. See the callus? Our dwarf wore a ring. But someone took it off him. See anything interesting on his legs?
His right foot. The ankle swollen, toenails broken. He clearly kicked something very hard. Right before he kicked the bucket.
Doesn't strike me as the right time for jokes.
Apologies. We surgeons, we've a different sensibility.
Mm-hmm. And a different sense of humor. All right. Think I know enough.
Enlighten me, please, because I've still no notion what this is about. What the motive might have been.
It's some kind of sick ritual. You saw it. Burns in the eye sockets, cavity where the heart should be, scalding liquid. All centering on warmth, heat, fire.
A fire eternal.
It's a lead worth following. Any idea what his name was?
Fabian Meyer. And I'm Hubert Reich, the coroner. I've come to perform the autopsy, but I see you've done it for me, Joachim. As always, you interfere where you're neither needed nor wanted. Drag others into trouble in the process. Who is this?
A student. Lifelong learner. Got a couple questions for you.
Very well, speak. But be quick. Reverend Nathaniel has come by for an inspection. He'll be here shortly.
Woodcarver's body. Where was it found? It's important.
Plan to investigate? Exciting. He died in his workshop south of the Market Square, just beside the gate to Far Corners. That poor Trebirons was attacked there. City's abuzz about it. But the woodcarver, Eustace the corpse collector, brought us the body. You should speak to him. Saw him just around the corner near...
Oh, greetings, Your Reverence.
Who are these people? I believe I made it clear no one's to be allowed in under any circumstances.
You did, but they're friends of the deceased, here to collect the body.
Out of the question. Show them out at once.
As Your Reverence wishes. Gentlemen, follow me. You shall leave via another route.
Why do you cover for us?
I was covering my own arse. If Reverend Nathaniel had learned someone had entered the morgue, then cut open a corpse without his permission, I'd be in deep trouble. But you didn't give that a thought, did you, Joachim? As ever. Well, while I don't approve of your willfulness, I also wish to see this murderer hang. So, should I learn anything new related to this case, I will let you know.
Thank you.
Might have told me you know the coroner. We could have skipped the trip through the sewers.
I know him, thus I avoid him. I've said enough on the subject.
Don't aim to press you.
Thank you. I've nothing to hide. It's just an old wound, unhealed as yet. What will you do now?
Plenty of leads. Woodcarver's workshop, the corpse collector who found him, alley where Priscilla was attacked. Got work to do.
As do I. At the hospital. I must return there. But I shall keep my fingers crossed.
And I'll keep my eye on you.
Monsters must have been there. The swarms in the sewer.
You, Eustace, the corpse collector?
I? How'd you know?
Fourth sense, I think it is. You bring Fabian Meyer's body to the morgue?
Fabian. Oh, yeah, I remember. No ice, no art, one of them, right? No purse neither, as I recall.
You search Fabian's body?
Well, I cast an eye in his pockets, made sure nothing went to waste.
I call a spade a spade. You rob corpses.
And I call a prick a prick. It's none of your fucking concern. What, you a tax collector? Peace off, mutant.
I'd advise you not to anger me, or you'll get an inside tour of the crematory.
Touch me, the guards will be hiding your ass before you count to three.
To save a little shit like you? Doubt it.
They's clever lads, more clever than you. They know Eustace, know they want me on their side. Cause you'll all die one day, and then I'll decide where your body winds up. A grave, the crematorium, or elsewhere.
That hard out for coin? Fine, have some. Now talk. What did you find on him?
Triflings, baubles, glass beaded wing, handful of coins, and a letter. Look, vellum. Quality parchment, that. I'll wipe off the writing and sell it as new.
That's human skin. Priscilla. Next victim's name. If you'd given this to the right person, she might not have been hurt.
What the fuck do I care what happens to some Priscilla? We short of wenches in this town. Oi, fucking hell! What was that for?
For everything.
Oi, Witcher! Coroner wants to see you. Been another victim. Told me to say the main door will be open for you. You're to come as soon as you can.
The wounds conform to the killer's modus operandi. The victim was bound and forced to drink formaldehyde. Next, the killer removed the eyes, placed burning coals in the sockets, then opened the rib cage and... What's this? A parchment. Made of human skin.
A message from the murderer. The name of his next victim. Patricia Vagelbud.
Gods, he knows no bounds. To attack Lady Vagelbud, heiress of such a prominent family.
Where is she? Tell me.
She resides in an estate beyond the city, north of Oxenford.
Gotta find her, now.
What do you want?
Need to talk to Patricia Vagelbud.
You think any bum off the street can...
Her life's in danger. Let me in or have her blood on your hands.
If you thought this up, and I'll let you in, I'll throw my arse out the door.
Always thought a guard was supposed to protect his charge, not his ass.
So be it. I'll take you to Lady Vagelbud. Just no trickery. Understand?
Yes, good fellow? If it's work you seek.
Don't know that I'm all that good. Name's Geralt. Looking for Patricia Vagelbud. Her life's in danger.
In danger? Come now. I saw Mother this morning. She seemed sad, true, but in perfect health.
I'm hunting a serial killer, and I've got reason to believe your mother will be his next victim.
Why, even if it's true, our gods...
He's exceptionally cruel when he kills, tortures his victims, cuts out their hearts. So let's see how she is, just in case.
I find this all very hard to believe, but you appear to be quite serious. Please, follow me.
A fire fit for Beltane, except it's the wrong time of year.
I mentioned Mother seemed sad. Do you remember? In fact, she's in the midst of a crisis of faith. A rather serious one. We'd been to Novigrad. Mother had seen the pyres in Hierarch Square, uttered not a word on our way home. She had all the holy books, insignias, reliquaries gathered, taken outside and burnt. Then she locked herself in her room.
We need to hurry.
Washed your hair lately?
Hear that? Calm and quiet. All seems to be in order.
We should go in, just to be sure.
You're relentless, aren't you? Fine. But wait here, please. Mother's certainly not in the mood for guests.
Put a bolt between your eyes!
Listen, you got the wrong guy.
Save your trickery, taking you to the heiress.
Well, killer's already escaped. Lead the way, hero.
We got him, Lady Ingrid. Wasn't easy, but...
Lower that crossbow before you hurt yourself. This man is innocent.
Forgive me. I saw him running. Thought it was the killer fleeing.
I was chasing him, and I'd have caught him if you hadn't gotten in my way.
Out of my sight, at once! Mother, why did he do this to her? Why?
Because she blasphemed the eternal fire, only thing that ties her to the other victims. Ingrid, I know this is a hard time for you, but usually the killer leaves a note on the body. A note indicating his next victim. May I?
Very well. But you should be on your own. I do not wish to see her in this state. I do not wish to remember her like that. And let her be the last victim. Please.
Here it is. Sweet Nettie, crippled Cates. Growing bolder, not just the name, but the place too. Won't get away this time.
Yet again you disturb me, and I so dislike being disturbed. I was to play with sweet Nettie, render her not so sweet, but I shall see to you first.
First, gotta tell me why you do it.
For pleasure. Satisfaction.
Achievable with whores in a lot of ways, many traditional. Doesn't take killing them, trust me.
Who said anything about killing? I could stop at a few burns. Third degree, but still. This rosy skin will roast quite well.
Spare me your lies. I've seen your victims. I know how they end. You don't stop. Not unless someone gets in your way. Like I'm doing now.
What the fuck are you on about?
Murder. You killed Fabian Meyer, Patricia Vagelbud, and many others.
Bollocks. You're mistaken, vagrant.
Found a message on Patricia's body. Led me here to crippled Kate's. To sweet Nettie. If you didn't leave it, who did?
I don't know. But I see we must talk calmly.
Who knew you'd be here?
Strangely enough, I don't announce these outings far and wide. There's but one man who... That's impossible. He treats even corpses with kid gloves.
The coroner said you were busy, that you wouldn't visit the morgue. Gotta go after him.
Go. But to Warehouse 12 at the docks. He's there this time of day procuring supplies. Formaldehyde. I shall stay here. I've unfinished business with sweet Nettie. After all, I paid in advance.
And I said, for the right price, of course. And then he smiled. Oh, God, it gave me the shivers. And then he hit me so hard I passed out. I was bound when I came to. And he was hitting the poker in the fire.
Calm down. He won't hurt you anymore. He won't hurt anyone. Run out of formaldehyde.
I underestimated you. You almost caught me in flagrante delicto. Now you've seen through my bluff with Nathaniel. Although, you've not divined all, I see. Had you, you would have drawn your silver sword.
Who, what are you?
A vampire. Higher, of course.
Got a reason for killing? A reason to torture?
I thought you'd figure that out as well. The symbolism's rather obvious. Coals for those who are blind to the fire. The egg of a salamander born of fire to replace their cold, doubting hearts. Fire down the throat.
Yeah, symbolism's clear. What's not is why a vampire would kill in the name of the eternal fire.
Should be equally obvious. I concur with the Church's diagnosis. Novigrad is a fallen city. Its population amnesiacs to the very concepts of decency and morality. So I decided to remind them, in a manner they'd be certain to notice.
There are other ways. Could have set up a soapbox in Hierarch Square, preached from it.
How funny. That's exactly what I did. But none listened. Instead, they laughed, threw stones. Give a thought to my victims. A lecherous woodcarver who'd spend his last copper on whores. An old countess who defiled symbols of the faith. A Trebiritz for whom nothing was sacred, nothing above ridicule. They did not deserve to live. But their deaths could be a lesson to others. Awaken them, scare them onto the correct path, the path to the fire, to cleansing, to salvation. For you, I'm afraid it's too late. You are a man of little faith. I sense this.
But I'm pretty good with a sword.
Pretty good. Might not cut it.
Time to end this.
Did you take care of what I asked?
Yeah. The Witcher's way.
Thank you, Geralt. From me and Priscilla.
Did my part. Your turn now. Take care of her. Good care.
I will. You'll see. Treat her better than the Dryads of Broccolon could.
She's talking again. Nice surprise.
Isn't it? Professor Von Gratz told me her wounds are healing faster than a troll's. Not the most flattering comparison, but encouraging. Maybe she might even sing again someday. For now, we'll try performing as a duo. She'll play the lute, I'll sing. Dandelion and Calinetta. Got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Sounds great. Good luck, Dandelion. On stage and off.